So in this video we will discuss pediatric oncology. So for this topic it will cover pediatrics as well as oncology. The most common tumors or most common pediatric malignancy. Most common malignancy are leukemias or blood cancers. So remember, in children leukemias are more common, solid tumors are less seen. If I ask most common solid tumor, these are brain tumor. Most common extracranial tumor other than brain, it is neuroblastoma. Neuroblastoma is basically an intra-abdominal tumor. So one by one we'll discuss some of these tumors which are seen in pediatric age group. First is ALL, acute lymphoblastic leukemia. For this ALL we are having a French, American, British classification, that is FAB classification. As per this FAB classification we are having L1 type, which is most common type, then L2, then L3. Most common type is L1 type, and this L1 type is having best prognosis amongst all these three types. The another classification that we use based on immunophenotyping, that is pre-B-cell, B-cell or T-cells. Pre-B-cell type ALL, B-cell type ALL, and third one is T cell type. This is another classification. Pre B cell is most common type. This T cell type is having a bad prognosis. So sometimes they ask a question which is a common, repeated many time as MCQ: what are poor prognostic factors of ALL? We will discuss some of the factors which are poor prognostic factor in ALL. It is age less than 1 year or more than 9 years. This will have a bad prognosis. Hyperleukocytosis. If leukocytes are more than 50,000, this will have a bad prognosis. Male sex is a bad prognosis. Why? The reason is testes are usually site for relapse. Hypodiploidy. Translocation 411. There is one more translocation known as translocation 922. This translocation 922 is also known as Philadelphia chromosome. Whereas translocation 411, it will give rise to infantile type of leukemia. Then we have discussed these two things, T cell type and L3 type. These are poor prognostic factors in ALL. How you will manage? The treatment of ALL is done by VAPD regimen. This V stand for vincristine. A is asparaginase. We basically use L form of asparaginase. Prednisolone, and D is doxorubicin. This is first line of treatment that we call VAPD regimen. The second way is, if for CNS prophylaxis, we use intrathecal methotrexate. And third drug that we can add later on is cyclophosphamide. So this L-aspartinase is an enzymatic derivative. This drug is having a side effect. It can lead to pancreatitis. It can lead to pancreatitis. Doxorubicin is cardiotoxic. Vincristine causes peripheral neuropathy. Prednisolone is a steroid. Steroids will have a lot of side effects. In ALL, there is one more thing, that is translocation 1221. This 1221, if you see this 12 in the mirror, it will look 21. This type of translocation is known as mirror image. This translocation 1221, if this mirror image is present in ALL, this will carry a good prognosis. A few minutes before, we discuss translocation 922 and translocation 411, which are having bad prognosis, whereas translocation 1221, which is a mirror image, it will carry a good prognosis. The second type of leukemia that we are going to discuss is AML. This AML is most common leukemia associated with Down syndrome. It is associated with Down syndrome. The Down syndrome patient also possess. They also may have ALL. So Down syndrome, the most common leukemia is AML. The classification of AML is basically we divide this like M2, M3, M4, M1, M2, M3, M4, M5. Out of this, the most significant is M3 type. This M3 type is also known as acute promyelocytic leukemia. In this type, you will see DIC. It is associated with translocation of 1517. This translocation 1517 code for retinoic acid receptor or RAR. And this M3 will carry a good prognosis. Good prognosis because this retinoic acid receptor, the drug that we use here is ultra-trans-retinoic acid. M7 type is classically associated with Down syndrome. In all these forms of AML, the histopathological finding that we see is presence of intracytoplasmic rods known as Oyer rods. Oyer rods. Next, we are having lymphomas in pediatric age group. So lymphomas, as you already know, they may be Hodgkin's lymphoma or they may be non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. Hodgkin's lymphoma, non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. The staging system that we use for Hodgkin lymphoma is Ann Arbor staging system. Ann Arbor staging. Whereas for non-Hodgkin, what we use is St. Jude staging. Hodgkin lymphoma are having different subtypes, which we have discussed previously in our lecture. Mixed cellularity, nodular sclerosis, lymphocyte rich, lymphocyte depleted, and lymphocyte predominant. Whereas non-Hodgkin lymphoma, it may be B cell type or T cell type, where we discussed follicular cell lymphoma, Burkitt lymphoma, diffuse large B-cell lymphoma, marginal cell lymphoma, maltoma, mantle cell lymphoma, hairy cell leukemia, adult T-cell leukemia, and mycosis fungoides. So these are Hodgkin's and non-Hodgkin lymphoma that we see. Next type of tumor in the brain that we see is brain tumors or CNS tumors, brain tumors in pediatrics age group. Most common tumor in first year of life is choroid plexus tumor. First year of life it is choroid plexus tumor. 1 to 10 year of age group you will see infratentorial tumor. Infratentorial, and after 10 years or in adults basically you see supratentorial tumors. Just remember, this choroid plexus tumor is also a type of supratentorial tumor. So in the children's, the most common tumor is gliomas. These gliomas are tumor of glial cells. So there can be a low grade glioma. This low grade gliomas, the most common variant that we see in children is known as pilocytic astrocytoma. This pilocytic astrocytoma basically mainly it affects cerebellum. A high grade glioma, or you can say a high grade glioma, is seen basically in adult. This is known as glioblastoma multiforme or butterfly tumor. Some other tumor that we see in the brain in children are medulloblastoma. It is a midline infratentorial tumor, and ependymoma is a tumor that arises from ventricles lining. The brain tumor, this is the latest question, the brain tumor that arise with calcification and some endocrine manifestation in children, the brain tumor which show calcification, some endocrine features and some features of compression of optic chiasma, this tumor basically arise from Rathke's pouch. And this is known as craniopharyngioma. Craniopharyngioma. Next pediatric tumor is neuroblastoma. Neuroblastoma. The most common location of neuroblastoma is adrenal gland. It can occur in the aorta. It can occur in the aorta. So this tumor is having basically certain stages like stage 1, stage 2, stage 3, stage 4. So stage 1, stage 2, stage 3, and stage 4. Stage 1 is a localized tumor. The lymph nodes are negative, means not involved here. Stage 2 is also a localized with incomplete gross excision, so lymph node may be positive or may be negative. Stage 3 is an unresectable mass, and lymph nodes are always positive. And stage 4 is a dispersed tumor, that is metastasis. There is one more stage that we should be knowing, that is known as stage 4S. This is a localized tumor It's a localized tumor with dissemination into skin. Sometime into liver or bone marrow. The special feature of the stage 4S tumor is it carry a better prognosis. Sometime it is better than stage 2, 3 as well. This is a good stage, stage 4S. The staging system that we use for neuroblastoma is INSS. It is International Neuroblastoma Scoring System. In neuroblastoma, sometimes we can see periorbital lichymosis that we know as raccoon eyes. Raccoon eyes. So there will be catecholamines levels increase in the urines for metastatic tumor. We use iodine 123 MIBG scan. So increase catecholamines in the urine and iodine 123 MIBG scan. Next tumor, Wilms tumor. Wilms tumor. It presents with asymptomatic abdominal mass associated with certain syndrome like Wagner syndrome, Dunning-Drasch syndrome, and Beckwith-Wiedemann syndrome. Beckwith-Wiedemann syndrome. The Wagner syndrome is Wilms tumor, aniridia, growth. Genitourinary abnormalities and retarded growth. Dunning-Drasch syndrome is having 100% association with Wilms tumor. Here you will see refractory nephrotic syndrome and pseudo hermaphroditism. Beckwith-Wiedemann syndrome is associated with organomegaly and hemihypertrophy. Single important prognostic marker. The most important prognostic marker is histology. Histology means the level of differentiation. It is most important prognostic marker. Most important prognostic marker is histology.